Let's see what we can do with it. The way structured with this presentation really is to introduce ourselves. We come from two different backgrounds, two different sources, and just tell you how we've come together. After introduction, we want to really look at the situation which is there. What are we trying to do in Garhwal? What is this group trying to do as far as the economic livelihood issue in Kumau and Garhwal both go across? There's a complete economic shutdown of the state right now, and that's what we want to talk about and what we can do about it. And then there's questions and answers if anybody has at the end of the session. It shouldn't take more than 45 minutes to 50 minutes, and we have some visuals to show you to capture really what is happening. Okay, I'll give you an introduction of myself. My name is Pankaj Wadhwa, and I was basically in the corporate world for the last 21 years to run an advertising and promotional marketing company. I sold that 5 years ago to Mudra Communications and moved to Uttarakhand, so now I live between Delhi and Uttarakhand. Home is in Delhi and home is in a village called Basgaon, which is 1 hour below Almora. Having gone to Uttarakhand, the idea was to do something there, and after spending a lot of time trying to figure out what the best solution was, it really came out to work in livelihoods here. So that's how Hinjodi was born. Hinjodi came into existence about 4 years ago. We basically work with 28 groups in Uttarakhand. This is both on the Garhwal side as well as on the Kumaon side. These are NGOs, these are self-help groups, these are women groups, they're producer groups, but all owned by the community. We basically work with three kinds of people, which is farmers, weavers, and beekeepers, and women that lead. So this is the group that we basically work with. When we started out, there were about 5,000 people in this group that used to work, used to make products. So we make a whole range of products in the mountains. There are acorn products, there are lamps, there are chocolates, there are herbs, there are soaps, there are trays, diyas, teas, seasonings, honey, herbs, apricot products, and handicrafts. So there's a whole range of products that's made in the mountains, and Hinjodi helps market this. So we bring it to market. There's also woolens, scarves, a whole range of products. Some of the products outside, you can take a look at this. This group is 5,000 people right now. And the average annual income when we started out 4 years ago was 1,100 rupees a year. So these 5,000 people that work at the back end of Hinjodi earn 1,100 rupees a year as annual income before we came in. The idea is really to increase this 1,100 rupees to about 5,000 rupees in the next 4 years and increase the numbers from the current 5,000 to about 15,000. So that's the goal of Hinjodi, and that's how we started out before this crisis came up. We take the products to the market in different ways. So this is the whole range of products, and we take these products to the market in different ways, like I said. The first way is we have our own Hinjodi shops. We have 10 stores. They're called Hinjodi stores, and they're mostly in the mountains where it's cheaper for us to put it up. So you'll find these stores in Nainital, you'll find them in Rishikesh, you'll find them in Mussoorie, you'll find them in Kasar Devi, you'll find them all over the hills. And we have one shop in Delhi at Aurobindo Window Place Market. So the 10 stores across Kumaon, Garhwal, and Delhi. We have 12 counters again across Kumaon, Garhwal, and Delhi, and also in Bangalore. We run a large direct operation, which means we take part in events, we take part in melas, we take part in any place we can connect with people like you. And the largest component is Diwali sales, where we go to corporates and say that this year instead of giving mithai, why don't you give our products and give back to the community. So this in a nutshell is what Hinjodi does as far as the product business goes, which is bring products to the mountains, provide market access, and 100% of this money goes back to the community. Apart from this, we also run a small corporate engagement program where corporates come into Uttarakhand and they contribute money and resources. This is the Ernst & Young group that does tree planting. They plant 100,000 trees a year, and it's a commitment for 5 years. So we get 500,000 trees in a degenerated area of Kumaon and Garhwal, and they get their carbon cover. And the last thing that we do in Hinjodi is this entire concept of medical treks. When we go to a region called Pindari, this is the Pindari Valley of Sundarlunga, Kafni, and the Pindari glaciers. These are completely marginal villages here. So people haven't gone here, doctors haven't been here for 7 years. So it's a team of doctors that go up that you see here, they're mostly volunteer doctors. So it's doctors, nurses, and dais that go up. And we do 5 villages in 5 days. So it's medical checkups, dispensing of medicine, minor surgery, and referral. These are the medical camps that you see. We do this thrice a year. Now it's coming out twice a year, but it's about 2 to 3 times a year. And we basically engage with the community in this area, and it's medical care that we look after.